1-to-1 correspondence. Interesting examples, part 2. So children, in the previous video, you saw some examples in which you made pairs of two objects used together in a task. In this video, we will see another interesting example of 1-to-1 correspondence. Today is Chotu's birthday and his friends have started coming one by one. Chotu's mother brings Chotu's birthday cake. Then Chotu cuts the cake.
Let me now cut a piece of cake for each of the children. Hey, but I don't know how many children I have to cut the cake for.
Mom, cut the entire cake into pieces and then give us all a piece each.
Oh yes, Chotu, this is very easy. This piece is for Aarti. This one is for Sonu. This one is for Neha. And this one is for Chotu.
Yay! We have all got a piece of cake.
Yes, Chotu. Although I didn't know how many children I have to give the cake pieces to. But as per your idea, I made a pair of one child and one piece of cake and gave each child a piece. Thus all the children got a piece of cake. Similarly, when we do not know the number of any two things and we want to find out whether they are equal in number or not, then we can find this out by making a pair of those two things.
This is fine, Mom. But what about the remaining pieces of cake?
Does any child want one more piece?
All the children raise their hands.
Everyone needs one more piece. This is for Aarti and this is for Sonu. Oh, the pieces of cake are over. Never mind. Come on, Aarti. You share your piece with Neha. And Sonu, you share your piece with Chotu. This way, everyone will get the same quantity of cake.
Did you see how all the children had a lot of fun eating cake? So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned how to compare the number of objects by pairing them. I hope that you have understood this topic properly. Bye friends!